10,000 subscribers. I finally reached 10,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel. It is a very great success for me because I thought I never gonna reach 10,000 subscribers, and everything is thanks to you. And today I am very happy to know that I have 10,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel, which is very impressive, as I said before. Knowing then the way I do my videos is not very, very advanced, like with many technologies as other people do, but I try to do the videos as informative as I can. So in celebration of my 10,000 subscribers, I'm gonna give some information about myself. I know many people want to know who I am and what I do and all this stuff, so I wanna talk a little about me, so you know who Francisco Amaya is, if you wanna know who I am. Well, as everybody knows, I have an accent. That means then I am not from this country. My country is El Salvador. I was born in El Salvador. But it's been really hard for me going to this transition on my YouTube channel because we are in the time where the hate against Hispanic is very hard, especially with the president on power at this moment, and he, for some reason, he goes against Hispanic people. And thanks to that, I've been receiving a lot of comments about the same situation. I've been receiving comments about, oh, go back to your asshole country, or this guy doesn't even speak English very well, and he trying to teach you something and stuff like that. And my YouTube channel is not about being hateful. My YouTube channel is about helping people. It was very hard for me to keep going doing videos, especially when people was complaining about my race, basically. But that's the way it is. Everybody has different opinions about something. But overall, my spirit of superation is strong enough. I have really good desire to be successful in life. That's why I keep my YouTube video. I kept doing it. No matter what they say, no matter what they wanna talk about, I didn't care about that. I just wanted to be someone in life. That's why I kept working and working and working on my YouTube channel. And happily, I reached 10,000 subscribers, which makes me very happy. And not even 10,000 subscribers, I have almost 2 million viewers, which is a lot to me. And also, I am very happy that I am showing people that not all Hispanic people is bad. I am Hispanic, and I showing that I help a lot of people, no matter what kind of people is watching my videos. From this country or other countries, I just help in general because that's the way I like to do things. I like to help people. I like to be helpful to people. So I am showing the country that I am the different, and I am making the Hispanic race look better because I am Hispanic, and I'm showing that I am the one that is making this big difference overall. I start working on the mechanic field, on the automotive field, when I had like 13, 14 years old. When I was that age, I saw the freeze engine completely apart. That's when I start my career as a mechanic. So right now, at this moment, I have 30 years. I'm going to be 31. On August, so that makes me like what, 16, 17 years of experience being around engines and cars and trucks. Well, with trucks it's different because when I start working with trucks, I had like 18 years old when I started working on trucks. That was on 2008, something like that, and that was where I started working on trucks. It was very hard for me going to this industry because I didn't speak the language back then. I was new in the country, I didn't know much, so that gave me a really bad position. When I started working on trucks, I was getting paid $100 per week, working 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. and working Saturdays as well. So I was working 6 days, 12 hours for $100 per week. That was something really, really bad. No matter in what kind of eyes you look at it, $100 per week, that's nothing compared to the amount of time you wanna be spending at work. But I didn't have no choice. I wanted to be in a different place to get more money. I wanted to quit because I wanted to get more money, but I didn't know anything. I was afraid. I was just afraid to fail, because everybody will be afraid to fail, and I was back then. But I kept going. I resist. I wanted to just quit and get a different salary, a better salary, but I didn't. I just kept working at the same place for 2 years, hoping that one day I was going to win more money. And well, I did. At the end of 2 years, I was getting like $400 per week. That was not too bad, but still, it was like a little okay. But I was still working like 9 to 9, so it was a lot of time at work. Anyway, that was my start as a truck mechanic. It was really hard, but thanks to that, thanks to those $100 per week, I became this, because I didn't give up. I didn't actually quit. I just kept going in the straight line because I didn't know what to do, but I had a hope that one day everything will be better, which it is now. So after those 2 years, I went to a different mechanic shop to get more money, supposedly $600 per week. And yes, I went to a different mechanic shop and I did get $600 per week, like for 2 weeks, something like that. And then I worked for 6 months and I was getting paid $600, but there were weeks then I was not getting salary at all. So at the end, when I quit that place, I have to pay them back because some tool then was missing and stuff. So when I went to work to that place, I ended up losing money actually. So I was regretting my decision, but that decision put me in the route to go all the way here. After that, I went to another shop to work, and I started getting $100, I mean $600 per week, and I was good. I was getting $600 per week and everything, and the guy knew that I was really good. So at the end, I was getting $1,000 per week on 2012, something like that. I was getting 2,000, I mean $1,000 per week on 2012. That was really good back then, and still really good today, $1,000 per week. But that wasn't enough for me, so I had the opportunity to meet someone, and we kind of like make some deal, and I finally got able to make my shop. And I did. On 2013, I started working on my own shop, and it was really bad because, you know, business are up and down, up and down. There is no stable business. You gotta learn how to manage your up and your down, up and down, because otherwise you're gonna just crash. So I did. I went down and I almost crashed. Almost, I was just this bit to crash, and I didn't. I actually was about to quit my shop because I didn't have no other choice, but I didn't. I just like don't give up. I didn't give up, and I kept going. And yes, I passed that really hard down crash position than I was. I went up again, and then after that, on 2017, I started my YouTube channel, hoping that I will do something good, and I did. And up to date, I got 10,000 subscribers, and I have some other stuff, some other investments all over. I am owner of my own shop. I am owner of my own property. I am owning so much stuff. So, for the people that thinks then business are bad, that's not true, because business, all business are good. The business will be good or bad depending on how you manage it, or how you invest your money or spend it. Because there is no such thing as a bad business. The only bad thing is how you manage your money. That depends on that. I have it. I have that completely proved, because I did that. In the past, I was not managing my money really well, but after that, I learned how to manage my money, and that's the reason why I went up. And now I am in a position that I never knew I wanna be, but I don't wanna stay here forever. I wanna climb and climb and climb, because I like to have a progressive personality. I wanna be farther and farther, farther beyond every single time. Because that's the way people gotta be. You just don't wanna settle in one place. You gotta think about tomorrow. You gotta think about tomorrow, and someday it will be better. I am willing to do more stuff little by little. I know people still contacting me on my location and stuff like that, and where I am, and many situations like that. I just tell you to please be patient. I cannot like have you all come to my place, because I cannot give you the service that you deserve at this moment. If I do have you come, I won't be able to give you the service. I want to give you 100% clean service, the one you expect from me. And for that, I need more people to work for me, but I need to have the right people, because most of the problems with shops are that they hire just random people from random places, and they ended up hurting their shop's names because the personnel that works at the shop is not good. Maybe the owner of the shop could be good, but the personnel is not good. So I want to avoid that. And to avoid that, I need to research and get the right personnel for my shop, and then I wanna make my shop bigger, and I wanna have you come so you can at least talk to me if you want. Now, I have different plans, I have different ideas about my YouTube channel, which I'm going to be posting on my community over here, my community section over here. I wanna be adding different ideas and stuff like that. Everything that I'm asking here is not because I just wanna know about you, it's because I have ideas of what to do. So, other than that, everything is the same. I wanna keep posting new videos every time. There are great content coming soon. You wanna see my videos coming. They are so good for all of you. Many people are asking for videos, new videos, new videos. Most of those videos, I have them ready for you, but they will be every single Saturday in English, and Spanish is going to be on Sunday. If you speak both languages, it will be better for you. If you don't, well, you can learn Spanish, and you're gonna have two different videos at the same time. So you can learn two different things. You can learn how to repair your truck, and you can learn Spanish, which will be plus plus, right? I hope you like this video. If you like this video, always use the like button over here to give some likes to my videos, so I can get more motivated to keep making great content for all of you who wants to learn more. Any comments, anything to add to this video, any helpful or any type of comments, you can use the comment section below, which is this one over here, on each video, and you can leave as many comments as you want. That's not a problem. As long as they're not hateful comments, they will be there. So, like, share, subscribe, and thank you for watching.